So you find that some people, when they start a business, they are not listening to the market needs. And somehow you find there is either a shift in the market or people are no longer interested in their product. So before even a year, they've already closed business. That's on their personal, you know, personal attributes of that they should, maybe initiatives that they should have taken as business owners. But largely, as I said, I think people are just not, we as Ugandans, we are not investing in enough time to research about what we are starting as a business idea and what the market is actually interested in.
There's too many reasons, really. If you ask me to pinpoint a few, you know, there's just too many dynamics involved. Whether it's the team, whether it's the, is the market ready for it, or whether it's your product is going after the right market. There's just too many reasons why startups fail, right? But I think if you boil down to a few components, the few that we can talk about, it's basically, have you done enough market research? Is the market ready for your product? And in terms of scaling, are you building a product that is sustainable? And what is the next step for you to grow your product?
The banking sector, I think, which is a role of government again, you find that young businesses do not have access to credit. So it's difficult for them also to get certain, you know, maybe certain operational costs covered as they run their business. So people are forced to close.
Innovate locally. We have to come up with our own solutions. I think a lot of businesses fail because they're just trying to copy someone else. Oh, I saw that one has worked this way. Let me just do it that way. You don't really know what they went through, the challenges, the full story, as you said. I think we're very impatient as Africans, especially young people. They want to start a business today and be rich in 2 weeks, which is just very unrealistic. And I also blame the media for that a lot. I think people watch movies or see success stories or interviews, and they just see the good part. They don't see the struggle and the time it took and the painful moments. One of the reasons I agreed to do Business Revolution is I didn't want it to just be another like business show where we highlight successful people's success. That's why I asked them what they went through, what the story was, where did you come from, where did you start? People are always impressed by my father's story of how he started selling sugar when he was 13 and now where he is. But from 13 to who he is today, that is a long story. There is a lot of hardship in there. There are a lot of difficult moments. And I think we need to show that more as entrepreneurs, as storytellers, in the media, in movies, in TV. We need to be honest, but it's part of our African culture to hide the bad things. Only show good things. Don't let people see you struggle or vulnerable or problems or when you're down. And I think that is negative. That is what is encouraging the youth to think that they can make start a business and be driving a Range Rover in 3 months. And it's not sustainable. It's not the right attitude. And I tell you this, it takes 10 years to make a successful business. 10 years, not one or two or five, 10. All the success stories that you see on TV or you see in Forbes or you see these companies that have IPOs or now worth $1 billion, you ask them where they were 10 years ago. That company started already. You go look at their Wikipedia page. The company was founded 10 years before they made it big, and now they have billboards everywhere and everyone has heard about them, and the CEOs live in nice houses. It's a long, difficult struggle.